I ask those who will quite sincerely consider the use of internment powers as evil to answer honestly this question. Is it more of an evil than to allow the perpetrators of these outrages to remain at liberty? I cannot guarantee that the action we have now taken will bring this campaign swiftly to an end. We may yet have to endure as a community, but if we endure with courage and steadiness, the utter defeat of terrorism is sure.
When you're weary, feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I'll dry them all.
I think they have definitely in some ways. They aren't the deciding factor in how I view the world, but obviously a major event such as the Troubles in the past in Northern Ireland have affected my outlook. I think there's a certain feeling of not guilt, but definitely being aware that there were a lot of people hurt during the Troubles, and sort of a sensitivity of nearly not wanting to bring it up so you don't cause people any more pain.
Not particularly my outlook, however, it still affects our country's outlook with recent riots with flags and violent outbursts with the different sides of the community.
Because I've seen people like disrespecting each other's cultures, and now it's like really important to me that I respect everyone, like no matter what they're doing, and like it's just important to like not think that your culture is better than anyone else's, and just to let them get on with it and you get on with yours, but like also take an interest in theirs as well.
Well, it makes me a bit more scared, sort of thing, if somebody, somebody could attack me just because of my beliefs, that sort of like makes you a bit more cautious. But then it doesn't really, like, it depends what crowds you're, with. Sort of thing.
My parents were both here during the Troubles, but now they don't treat anybody differently. They just want peace between everybody. Both of them work with people from different cultures, and they just get on with it without much thought.
My parents were largely affected by the Troubles. My dad grew up in Londonderry, which was a very divided city. It had a lot of conflict. There was a lot of violence. My dad grew up in times when he had to run away from riots, when people were shot, when you could hear bombs going off. And my mum's dad was in the police. So that was something that always scared her a lot, because he was constantly had that threat of being killed. He had to check under his car for bombs every day before work. He had to take different routes home. There was always a sense of sort of fear and danger around them. Now, how that's affected them, I think they have a real sort of looking, a real caring nature. They look out for others, and I feel like they have a real emphasis on peace.
They don't treat anyone differently now, and they've just like never really had a hatred to anyone else.
Okay.
I'm originally from Latvia, so coming in, in Latvia, there isn't a divided culture. Everyone sort of gets along. There would be maybe a dominant culture, but everyone gets along. But coming in here in Northern Ireland, there is a divide in the culture, and then there's a violence with it, which is a real negative kind of impact on different people coming in, or, you know, people living here. So it can be very hostile to people coming in, and that can be quite scary for the first time if you're not used to that sort of violence.
No, I think that there is still a divide between Protestants and Catholics, but now there are many integrated schools which bring people together. People hold the country back with their old-fashioned opinion of divides between cultures.
It's important to be allowed to do the things that you do in your culture, and that you have the freedom to do that without being judged by other people.
I think it is something that affects everyone in Northern Ireland. I definitely care. I think it is a massive problem. I think especially in our politics and our education, there's still a lot of segregation. But I think integrated schools like the one I go to, or projects that bring different people from different communities together, are very important for emphasising peace and good relationships between everyone.
Well, it ensures that, you know, that even other people looking in inside your culture, or even coming over, that they see your culture as positive. You know, they would want to be sort of living here or keep living here, even if, you know, you've lived here, you know, since the beginning. If you see a divide in the culture and the violence getting worse and worse, like, you might be thinking of leaving.
I think it's really important so that we don't get back to the way that we used to be, and like fighting with each other all the time. So it's important to build relationships with people from that are of a different culture, to be able to understand them better and get on with them better, and just treat them equally so that there's no more like rows, and everyone feels like safe and happy in their communities.
The outlook of this culture would be better if bridges were built. The future of this country will look brighter if the communities would be looking to build bridges instead of tearing the communities apart.
I think it's incredibly important. I think that if a country is divided, there is no real way to make progress. If we're constantly fighting amongst ourselves, there's no time to innovate and build and grow. I think that if Northern Ireland really wants to become a major player in industry and entertainment and all fields of life, we need to really step past this piece of our history and move on.